Boxing superstar Gervonta Tank Davis, the biggest name in boxing. It's him and Canelo Alvarez. They're in a league of their own, and then everybody else. No disrespect to everyone, but Tank is a superstar, and right now he's probably earning more money than any fighter anywhere around the planet. I'm not gonna say what he's doing, but he's doing big things. And Tank really doesn't need nothing from anybody. He is a superstar. 11 sellouts in a row, highest pay-per-view in years, him and Ryan. As Gervonta Davis and Canelo Alvarez leading the pack, Canelo's made hundreds of millions of dollars, owns 90 gas stations, owns an energy drink, owns a lot of stuff, but Tank is a superstar. And really, if you want to succeed, and I love what the Saudis are doing, and I'm a big supporter, I've offered them help, I've gone out there, I've sent crews out there, I've done what I can to help promote their stuff. They need Tank out there. Caliber of a Tank of Canelo is a game changer for them. If they have just the British fighters or other fighters, it's okay. It's good. It's good for England. But if they want the American crowd, if they want boxing to be good globally, and U.S. is the biggest boxing market, everybody dreams of making it in America. And for the Saudis to make it, having Tank there is an advantage for them. That's how big of a superstar Tank is. And I'm sure the Saudis know that he's a superstar, but maybe they haven't seen it. So for Tank's next fight, I'm going to reach out to the Saudis and invite them personally to come to his fight and see and experience it. And then it's going to be an experience like they've never had. Gervonta Davis, a fight against anyone whenever he's ready to go back in the ring. And obviously Tank will announce his fight. They're going to see. And I've already gotten offers from the Middle East for a Tank fight. And you're talking about upwards of $100 million for Tank to fight out there. So if the Saudis want him, which I'm sure they do at some point, it's going to be $150 to $200 million. That is what I think it would be. And people say he's outpricing himself. But you have to understand, when Tank does pay-per-views, that's the kind of money he's bringing in. So it's different with other fighters. Other fighters don't do those numbers. Their pay-per-views are way lower. What did Fury do with his last pay-per-view with Ngannou? I saw something about 11,000 buys. I don't know if that's accurate. But you had other fighters with pay-per-views very, very low. So Turki Aşık, he spoke to Ariel Helwani about Gervonta Davis saying he wants two Ferraris sent to his door to discuss him fighting in Saudi. And Turki says, I heard Davis said, send me two Ferraris. I say to him, we'll send you two boxing gloves. And it's one of those things where it benefits everybody if Tank is involved. And right now, Tank obviously is PBC. Obviously, he's with Al. And you're talking about doing the biggest events with Tank. It's hard really to explain to people who haven't seen it or experienced it or understand what Tank has reached, how big of a super, wherever Tank fights, whether he fights in the U.S., in England, anywhere, he is the draw. Like I said, him and Canelo in the league of their own, and that's a compliment to both of them. Canelo is a superstar. Tank is a superstar, and they've crossed over. And I remember telling other promoters in the United States 5, 6, 7 years ago that Tank is a crossover, and they were arguing with me that Tank is only big in certain markets, that he's only good with African-Americans. And I told them that is far from the truth, because Tank has sold out Los Angeles. He sold out New York. He sold out in England. He sold out Atlanta, Baltimore, San Antonio, Houston, wherever he's fought, he's sold out. It has nothing to do with race. People love great athletes. People love superstars. So when it comes to Tank, he is that guy. And I know there's a handful of haters in boxing that make noise like millions of people, but it's just a handful. People vote by the numbers. Tank's doing the paper. Tank's doing the sellouts. Record gate in D.C., record gate in L.A., record gate in New York, record gate in Vegas. Fifth biggest gate in Vegas history, him and Ryan. So It's different things. And like I said, right now the Saudis are focused on the British market, and that's why they're going with the British fighters like the Furies and the Joshuas. And that's okay. They're England's a big boxing place, but so is Mexico. And so is the United States. So obviously, Turki knows what he's doing. It's his game. It's his money. No one can tell him how to spend his money. No one can tell him where is he doing it. But if he has the biggest name in boxing involved, it's going to help what he's trying to do. But Tank, as you just saw, he's not desperate. He's not thirsty. Tank said, when did I even need them? And yes, nobody needs anybody. They're doing their thing, good for them. Tank doing his thing, good for him. He's doing great. And they're doing great. Everybody wins. Everybody's their thing. If they got together, amazing, wonderful. But even if they all say it's good for boxing, there's a lot of options. People can fight where they want. Now, I've seen some responses to Tank comments saying, hey, we wish other fighters did what Tank did, and not go for the guy paying the most, but keep it for the integrity of the sport, and so on and so forth. But boxing is also a business. And I couldn't be mad at any fighter that's going to make record paydays if this is what he does for a living, and he has to feed his family, and he's the one taking his punishment. It's his health on the line, and it's his well-being on the line. So you can't be mad at people for pursuing the biggest pay. But at the same time, they're commending Tank for standing his ground. But Gervonta Davis, he is, I'll kind of explain it to you, as they said this about Benavidez, but they'll say this about Tank. He's your favorite fighter. Canelo, Mike Tyson, Mayweather, Pacquiao, all have had great, great compliments about Gervonta Davis, how much they love him and appreciate him, how great he is. And Manny Pacquiao is actively trying to fight Tank. He's mentioned it his team. I met up with members of his team this week, and they told me that that Manny Pacquiao is interested in a Tank fight, and they want him actually to fight Crawford. They feel that Crawford will be an easier fight for Pacquiao than Tank. They feel Tank would be too much of a challenge for Manny Pacquiao. That's what Team Pacquiao said. But it's up to Tank to decide who he fights next. I've seen 7, 8, 9 different names float around, and everybody's an expert. It's up to Gervonta Davis. It's his career. It's his life. And guys, when he's ready to announce what he does next, let him to announce. So, is the chapter with him and Saudi sealed, delivered, and over? Absolutely not. It's business. And people say things, but they haven't met face-to-face. And in 2 seconds, they could hash it out. I know after the Ngannou Fury fight, a lot of people in Saudi told me that they were very mad at Fury. They were very disappointed in his performance and his seriousness. But you see, they forgave him, and they gave him a chance. And now he's weaseled his way out of the second Usyk date. And now there's a third date, which, according to some boxing stars, that's not enough time to heal from such a cut. You're talking about 3 months, and it takes a couple months, and then after that, he'll only have a very short time of sparring. So very strange things going on. I still don't trust anything Fury. Anything with Fury, I have to have 2, 3, 4 security checks. It just, that's his reputation, that's who he is, and it's always some kind of drama involved with him. Always. Wild boar, the drug use, there's always something. There's always a question mark when it comes to Tyson Fury. So he pulled out of a Klitschko fight. He pulled out of a Wilder fight. Wilder had to take him to court for the third fight. He didn't want the third fight. David Haye mentioned that their fight was canceled when they were supposed to fight. And now the Usyk, December 27th, they were supposed to fight, got canceled. Now their new date is May 18. So you have to have reliable fighters that are serious, that respect the craft, and respect the fans. So we'll keep you guys posted. But Gervonta Davis, as I said this in the past, he is his own boss, and he calls the shots. So right now, he's good where he is. He's not desperate. He's not thirsty. But he is great for business if you're in a boxing business, and Gervonta Tank Davis is on your side. Stay tuned. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback. And one more thing, I want to be clear to some of the naysayers out there, even though they don't deserve a real legit response. How could Tank be afraid of anyone when he's their record payday? He's their dream fight. He is their moment to shine, moment to make a name for himself. Win, lose, or draw. You fight Gervonta Davis, 29-0, 27 knockouts. You get crazy famous afterwards, and you make crazy paydays. And people, you know, they critique, oh, who is Tank fought? But then everyone that says that run to fight anybody that he's fought, because now they're famous. Now they've made it. And just don't have it. Don't be a hypocrite. Don't be complaining about one thing and then acting in the exact opposite way. Keep that same energy. So if you complain about his opponents, why are you dying to fight them? Exactly. So Tank's a professional. He's not afraid of anyone. He'll fight anyone, any weight class. It doesn't matter. Any place, any time. But boxing, he's the A-side. He calls the shots. Just like Canelo in his situation, he's the A-side. It is what it is. You got to take it. Work hard. Get to that point. You become the A-side. You call the shots. That's why people work so hard. 29-0, 27 knockouts. I've seen so many fighters self-proclaim that this is their era. If this is your era, you don't need to proclaim it. The people say it. You don't say, I'm the best pound for pound, or I'm the face. You let people say it. And people recognize your greatness. If you're saying it, it doesn't add, it actually takes away. It kind of looks goofy. So stay tuned. I'm Ellie Secback, Ellie Secback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting. ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting.